The recent episode that occurred in Japan in March 2011 was associated with three events: earthquake, tsunami, and spread of radiations. The earthquake and tsunami were natural disasters, while the spread of the radiation was man-made disaster, and this resulted in nuclear hazards. Nuclear hazards are a result of radioactive or radiation pollution. Like noise pollution, radiation pollution is also invisible and have been considered as physical type of the pollution. All organisms have been exposed to low level of radiations from natural sources for many years. But hazards from radiation have increased recently due to nuclear work in many fields. Radiation pollution is caused due to addition of radiation, mostly ionizing type, to the environment through the activities of man, giving people an exposure to more such radiation than they normally would be exposed. According to Dr. S. P. Jemmet from Atomic Energy Commission, France, increase in radiation level emerging from activities of man involving the use of naturally occurring or artificially produced radioactive materials. Radioactive materials are those in which nucleus disintegrates spontaneously and giving energy in the form of radiations. Hence, radiation is release of energy from the nucleus of an atom. There are two types of radiations, non-ionizing and ionizing. Non-ionizing radiations are the radiations of short wavelength but with more energy content. This energy can excite the atom but does not produce ions. These are harmful to microorganisms but can injure only the surface tissue of higher plants and animals. These radiations are also known to increase the rate of mutation among the organisms. Light and radio waves are common example of non-ionizing type. Ionizing radiations concerning mostly with the pollution are having great energy content, and this energy can ionize atom and molecules both. By getting energy from radiations, electrons of atom are separated and it is called ionization. Ionization of a molecule yield charged and uncharged fragments. Uncharged fragments are called free radicals. Free radicals are chemically very active, and the most important type of the ionizing radiations from the standpoint of pollution have been alpha, beta, and gamma radiations. Alpha radiation is made up of energetic alpha particles. These are fast moving particles having two protons and two neutrons. Because of positive charge, they get deflected by negatively charged ions. These are less penetration in comparison to beta particles and gamma rays and X-rays. The epidermis of human skin deflects all the alpha particles to which it is exposed. Beta radiation is made up of energetic electrons, which are small but with high speed. They can ionize any matter coming in their path. Beta particles are more penetrating than alpha and cause internal damage to human body if inhaled or swallowed. Gamma radiations are made up of very energetic photons with short wavelength. Despite being uncharged, photons are able to bring about very strong interaction with the matter. Many other types of the ionizing radiations are also encountered less frequently, but they can also be dangerous to living organisms. Protons, neutrons, and deuterons with sufficient great energy are some common examples. Radiations are measured with different units like curie, Roentgen, rad, and rem. Curie is the most commonly used unit. named after the Madame Curie who discovered radium. It can be defined as the quantity of any radioactive material that gives 3.70 into 10 to the power 10 disintegration per second. This unit was defined so that 1 gram of natural radium together with its decay product amounted to 1 curie. Millicurie and microcurie units are also used. At present, curie is replaced by becquerel. 1 becquerel is the amount of radioactivity in a substance where 1 nucleus decays per second. Röntgen, named after William G. Röntgen, who discovered X-ray, and it is defined as the amount of gamma or X radiation that produced by ionization. Experiments showed that 1 Röntgen of gamma radiation lead to the absorption of about 97 erg per gram in soft tissue, and a new unit was defined as RAP, Röntgen equivalent physical, denoted a dose of 97 erg per gram of the body tissue. RAD, radiation absorption dose, may be defined as the quantity of radiation that leads to the absorption of 100 erg per gram of the absorbing material. For body tissue, it is closely matched with the RAP. RAM, Röntgen equivalent man, may be defined as the quantity of radiation that produces the same biological damage in man as 1 RAP of the gamma radiations. Different type of radiation seen to have different biological effect, and they can be characterized by their relative biological effectiveness. In the environment, the radiations are released by natural and man-made sources. Natural occurring radioactive elements like uranium, thorium and radium, etc., are releasing radiations in the form of alpha, beta and gamma rays. Some additional radiations are also produced from air, soil, rocks and groundwater by some interactions. Ultraviolet and infrared radiations are also coming along with the sunlight. In our body, muscles, during decay of potassium, some radiations are generated. Very minute quantity of uranium, thorium, strontium and carbon 14 are also present in the body. These radiations are mostly not harmful.
We have started talking about nuclear hazards or the hazards that arise from use of nuclear energy from a very long time, and the debate really started in 1945 when the first atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima. The after effects and the immediate effects of nuclear radiation were studied for a long time in Japan, and there is a lot of very good data available on nuclear hazards. The work was supplemented by some interesting work done in the laboratories on men as well as animals. However, very soon the lessons of safety got a little forgotten as we came into the age of nuclear power, and everybody said that nuclear reactors are extremely safe and there is nothing to really worry about it. There were two big accidents, one which is called the Three Mile Island in USA, the other was Chernobyl in USSR, which were very serious, and a lot of people got dislocated. Unfortunately, unlike the Japanese effect in by the bomb, the data from these is not freely available and not much is known really as to what happened. The recent events in Japan succeeding the tsunami and the earthquake, where a number of reactors failed and radioactivity got to a large extent in the sea, has set us thinking about the hazards of nuclear energy.
Man-made sources of the radiations are dangerous and includes ore processing, medical field, nuclear test, atomic power plants, fallout, electric field and electronic appliances. Mining, washing, refining and separation processes of radioactive ores like uranium, thorium and radium are resulting into the radioactive pollution. Pitch blende and uranites are common ores of the uranium. Uranium and thorium are used mostly in nuclear work. Use of X-rays and radioactive isotopes are becoming common in the medical field. X-ray are highly penetrating like gamma rays. Improper exposure during diagnosis means checkup due to untrained persons or defects in machine result in the health hazards. Similarly, overdose of radioactive isotopes to patients and improper handling also result in hazards.
It is used very much in medicine, and what was really generalized was that it is the high energy nuclear radiation which really counts. The radiation is of three kinds that we can talk about is one that arises from the nucleus, and these are, for example, the charged particles, which could be alpha particles, which could be electrons, which could be neutrons, which are not really charged, and then the gamma rays, which are just nothing else more than electromagnetic radiation. And of course, you have a whole range of things from X-rays and hard X-rays and harder X-rays. Then in medicine, if you do go, you are subjected to a lot of radiation when they are taking X-rays or when they are giving you treatment for cancer. So one has to understand what does radiation do. Now, all these harmful things have one thing in common, that they destroy the cell. Now, when you are trying to use it as a cure, you try to create conditions so that the diseased cell gets more, has a bigger chance of death than the normal cell. And therefore, we find that this thing could have advantageous effects, but the long term effects could still be there. Now, when we are undergoing cancer treatment, I think one has to be extremely careful about the amount of radiation dosage that you get, the total as well as the quantum by which you get it. We cannot really go any other way. As far as other things are concerned, one has to have play the safety. The other thing which is very important about nuclear radiation is that it is very long lasting. If a nuclear accident occurs today, the effects will last many years on the ground, and those people who have been on the ground, their generations can also suffer because there is a genetic transmission of the changes which occur due to the nuclear radiation.
Nuclear explosion test increases radiations in the environment and long-lived elements are released. Common long-lived elements includes strontium-90, cesium-137, barium-141 and iodine-131. to fulfill the increasing demand of energy, nuclear power plants are increasing in the number throughout the world. There are about 600 nuclear power plants in developing countries and 100 alone in USA. Accident in nuclear power plants result in great damage to the ecosystem. Waste of nuclear power plants are also dangerous. Gaseous and particulates like carbon-14 and iodine-129 are released in environment as stack emission. Heavy water, that is tritium, and heat are also released from coolants. None of the nuclear power plant is perfectly safe. Leakages may occur from various points. Fallout is a process in which radioactive matter gradually settles down on Earth's surface after nuclear explosion or accident. Radioactive fallout contains about 200 radioactive isotopes like carbon-14, strontium-89, strontium-90, and cesium-137. After settling, they enter in food chain and food web and result in health hazards. The biological magnification of many isotopes are also reported. Power transmission lines continuously emit low radiation in ambient environment. TV sets, mobiles and electronic ties are also releasing radiations in low concentration. Mobile towers are also not very safe. Radioactive pollution perspectives of North Indian cities like Delhi, Gurgaon, Chandigarh, Ambala and Panipat is dangerous. Average concentration of radiation recorded was between 4000 to 5000 microwatt per square meter. 19 and 25 kilowatt X-ray tubes used in TV sets are also dangerous. Radiations are affecting to all the organisms. Effects are mostly depending on concentration and time period. In plants, reduction of chlorophyll occurs and DNA is also affected adversely. In case of fruits and vegetables, it is found that by the effect of radiation, some toxic chemicals are produced. These toxic chemicals may change color and taste of fruit and vegetables. In case of animals, it is found that fish productivity is reduced and mortality of zooplankton increases. Human beings are also affected by radiations. Skin cancer called melanoma, lung cancer, breast cancer, cataracts in eye and leukemia are diseases resulting from radiations. Loss of hair, blood vomiting and reduction in WBC count are common effects on the human being due to the radiations. Bone marrow, reproductive system and functions of thyroid glands are adversely affected by the radiations. Dizziness, headache, fever and diarrhea are also reported due to radiation exposure. Radiations into the pelvic region of a pregnant woman may cause damage to the fetus and this may result in the birth of deformed children. Massive doses of radiations includes a collection of symptoms called as radiation sickness. Some control measures, if we follow them properly, then they can reduce the dangers of the nuclear hazards. Number one, during radioactive ore processing, all safety measures should be applied like wet drilling and underground drainage, etc. Number two, production of radioactive isotopes should be minimum and very careful use in the laboratories. Number three, nuclear medicines and radiation therapy should be given with extreme care and under the supervision of an expert. Number four, nuclear test should be banned to control the hazards of fallout radiations. Number fifth, nuclear power plant waste should be disposed with extreme care and following all rules and regulations which are internationally made. Sixth, establishment of nuclear power plant should be reduced and use of solar and wind energy should be promoted. Seventh, residential areas should be at a safe distance from the high tension electric line and mobile towers. Eighth, electric appliances like TV, mobile and computers should be used with all safety measures.